What's going on, guys? Today I'm gonna take the Rad Rover out for a ride on the trails and show you guys what I do on this thing and just what it can do. Hopefully you guys enjoy. Let's check this thing out.
Right off the bat, give it some juice. Get up around the corners, no big deal. Nice little hump. Just like so. This is where these types of bikes come in handy, because you're able to ride kind of at your leisure, and if you need a little juice, go ahead and give it some, and you can get up to the top of the hills like it's easy. No big deal. Another bank. Rough terrain. Right now I'm just giving it all battery, zero pedal assist, just kind of making my way around the trail. A little bit of pedal there too. It's hard to see on the camera, but it is steep enough to where the motor cannot get you up on its own. You're gonna have to give it some assistance. Rough terrain. See, now spots like that, if you could see it, there was two logs on the side of the trail. If I was to pedal, more than likely one of my pedals would have snagged on the stump and stopped me dead in my tracks. I know that because I've done it before. So another plus to having an e-bike are things like that. If you want to have your pedals horizontal and not one pedal low to where it's going to snag something, you can just give it some juice and get it around those tight spots, and then go back to pedaling if you need to. This would be a really hard trail to do just on a regular bike. Downhill would be okay, but uphill would be really difficult. Some rough stuff, some logs, some stumps, just getting over that. You can see I'm not even pedaling right now. And it's all strictly power from the motor. Now I'm gonna give it some pedal assist just to pick up some speed, because I know it was gonna lose juice. So now, it's just trails like this make it a lot easier to have an e-bike on. As I said, I don't know what I would do if I'd even attempt going up this on a regular pedal bike. Having the assist of the motor just makes things like this easy, doable. So it's not so bad. A little bumpy, it's okay. Can make ourselves around the way here. There we go, it wasn't too bad. Gear 4, pedal assist 5. It's a pretty settle trail from here on out, and then with the pedal assist, it's easy to get around. So, here we go. There's some pretty hard corners on this one. Like this one, you gotta get some speed for it. If not, you're gonna not make it. Pedal for that hill from here on out, just kind of let it coast. It's the best part about these e-bikes, you can pedal if you need to. When you have to, you pedal, but then if you need to take a break, this is a tough corner. Did I make it? Oh god. Whew. never do. I think I've made that one twice. Didn't have enough speed. All right. So we're gonna start off on an incline regularly. It'd be a little bit of a tough go, but with an e-bike, give it a little bit of juice and then we're off. Okay. Try not to let that happen again. That's a tough corner. I wasn't prepared for it. I was busy gabbing and talking. Didn't have enough speed. All right. Oh, deer. A couple of deer just jumped by. Okay. Trail's getting thin. Here we go. Woo! Perfect time of the day to be out here doing this. Golden hour. It's pretty hot today. It's probably 90. So, wanted to hang out in the house and let it cool down a little. Oh, shoot. Okay. Okay, back on it. Back on the trail. Again, didn't have enough speed. This GoPro, I had it mounted to my hat and it's just adding some odd weight to my head. So I'm going a little bit slower than I usually do. And that makes it all possible with an e-bike. Get some speed through this corner. Right on. There are a few solid urban lefts and urban rights on this trail. You gotta be ready for it. Ooh. Ah, right on. So again, we're pedal assist 5 on gear 4. That seems to be just fine. Right there, a little added bonus to having an e-bike. I needed to lift up on the front tire to get over those roots, so I just gave it some throttle. And that gave me enough momentum to just lift up on the tire and get over those humps. Okay. Okay. Oh. Okay. Isn't so bad. Yeah. And there's the bench we don't need to use because we're cruising on an e-bike. All right, we're gonna pick up some speed. Parking lot was empty. So, that means there's nobody on the trails. It's a Sunday afternoon. Perfect day to be on a trail, in my opinion, but hey, I guess that just means more room for me to lie around. Yeah. This used to be a really good spot for archery hunting, but due to the population in the northern west, the Coeur d'Alene, Idaho area, where now a lot of these spots are getting used up for parking and recreational use, which is fine. Yeah, just take it easy from here a little bit, just kind of let the motor take me up the hill and enjoy the view. Perfect sunset. Well, the sun's not setting yet, but it will be here once we get to the top of the ridge. It's one heck of a good view. We are picking up the speed. We're going 22. It's like nothing. Nice and easy. Got a little bit of a hill coming up, so I'm trying to get as much speed as I can. So So we're losing momentum on the motor. I'm gonna give it some pedal. I'm sitting down right now, so to show it's not, if you can see, I'm able to sit and pedal. So I'm not taking a whole lot of effort to get this bike going. All right, here we are. Here we are back on the trail, tearing it up. Doesn't get much better than this. Ooh, blue diamond. We're on a blue diamond. All right. All right. Woo. Slow down for the corners. Okay. Oh, yeah. That's a fun little trail there. Just kind of weaving out in through the trees. You gotta duck a couple times to get under the branches. Oh my God, we're on a blue diamond. Oh, look out. Woo! Like nothing. Like nothing. We're cutting through these trails like butter. A hot knife on butter. Yeah. So here I am, I'm pedaling again. The hill's too steep for the motor, so I'm gonna give it some assistance. Not much. I know if I was to take a turn off the motor completely, there's no way I'd be able to pedal up this trail, even at the lowest gear. So, and we're off. Nice little place to catch some speed. This trail gets good. From here on through, it's just such a cool view of everything. You're just like you're in the deep, dense part of the forest, and then once you get up to the top of the ridge, it opens up, and you can see Coeur d'Alene Lake. We'll be seeing that here real soon. So here we are, I'm back on a hill. I'm pedaling now at this point. Still having it on gear 4 and slight bit of a resistance on the pedals, but it's nothing crazy. Again, I'm sitting down, just kind of an easy pedal, really. Super nice. Yeah, baby. Getting up to the top of the hill here and back to a flat, so just sit back and let her coast. So for anyone that's in the Coeur d'Alene area, if you guys haven't checked out this trail yet, I highly recommend you do it. It's called Wally Forest. It's down off of Yellowstone Road. And ever since they started doing this trail system for bikes, it's really gotten to be a really fun place to come. And it's fairly close to my place, so it's easy to just go ahead and jump on the bike, ride down up on these trails. So it's a quick little trail ride though. I mean, it branches off into probably 10 different smaller trails that you could burn through all the trails in one day, no problem, especially with an e-bike. So this trail gets fun. Coming downhill now, gotta watch my brakes because there's some huge ruts and some logs and whatnot, so try to take it easy. Probably better on the footage too. It's not so bumpy if I go slow. Just making my way through the forbidden forest. The only guy up here. Alright. So right here, got a small incline. I'm just giving it some juice again. I keep wanting to say gas. One of you guys corrected me on that. Gas? What do you mean gas? There's no motor on that thing. Yeah, that is true. It's all juice. So I'm trying to break the habit of saying gas every time I give it gas. I need to say juice. Picking up some speed, making our way through. We actually might end up catching the sunset once we get up to the top of the bridge. I sure hope so. Yeah, we're picking up speed. We're going, yay, 18 miles per hour. I'd like to do another video where I try and do this whole trail system on either a regular bike or with this Rad Rover with the motor completely off and it's all pedal. Just to kind of give a more in-depth perception on how much of an assistance you get with these bikes. For those who don't have an e-bike. And I know before I had bought an e-bike, I was so on the fence with it because I didn't think it would provide much of an assistance. I was thinking it was just gonna be like a just a small bit of a power to get you around, but I went ahead, took a leap of faith, followed through with it, and yeah, okay, the power may not be as much as you would get clearly from a motorcycle or some other types of e-bikes that have more power, but it's surprisingly enough. It really is. It gives you the feeling of being on a mountain bike because you do have to help out the motor at certain times, but it's not like not that bad. Hill's getting steep. Check my brakes. I will say this, I have never done more maintenance on a mountain bike ever. I've gotten one of these, and that's mostly maintenance on the brakes. The pads I had to replace. The back pads were really bad. The fronts weren't too bad, but I went ahead and replaced those as well. But I don't think I ever rode a mountain bike enough to burn through pads before. I'd always lived in real hilly areas to where if you went down anywhere, you're gonna have one heck of a pedal on the way up. So mountain biking wasn't that much of a thing before e-bikes came out, and we had always just rode motorcycles. Well, this day and age anymore, all the good trails are blocked off to motorcycles, so you're pretty limited. So here we are, we're at the top of the ridge. I hope you guys can see this view. Look at that. Coeur d'Alene Lake, that's Beauty Bay. Well, I'm about to go off the trail because I'm not paying attention. Down there is where I lost my drone. If anybody had seen that video about the Mavic water rescue, that was right down there where I lost it. And you guys should check that out. I think I called it the underwater Mavic rescue or some shit. So I don't remember. But it's a good video. I documented the whole thing on how I got the drone, and was quite the defeat. I didn't think it was gonna work. I'm not gonna give it away, but you guys should check it out. Alright, so this trail gets a little hairy coming up. Just gonna take my time. This is a tough corner, and I know it's not gonna look that bad on the GoPro, but this thing is a doozy. It's so steep, and it's an urban left-hand corner. So, like, once you go around it, like, you're picking up speed, and if you go off the trail, you're gonna be endoing head over tea kettle all the way down the hill, like that scene from Hot Rod, which I don't want to do. So I'm gonna try to take it down without being a wuss and putting my feet down. If I eat hard, well, at least I'll have it on video. Let's try this out. Oh yeah, skid that back tire around the corner just like that. We made it. No big deal. All right, gonna pick up some speed. The trail gets real narrow, so you can kind of see where these little roots are on the side of the hill. And again, like, this is where if you had to pedal, you're probably gonna bust a pedal or two off because it's gonna hit the side of the hill. But with these e-bikes, you can lift the 1 foot up and clear those low spots and get by just fine. Yeah. All right. This is where it gets good. We're just hauling. Ooh, ooh. Gets thin. Gets real narrow. Some of these spots. Oh God. Best time of the day, guys. Right here. Make it through the trails. Let's see here. No pedal assist. 16 miles per hour. Just flying. Of a fun trail that didn't take too long. So here you can see I've got 538 overall miles on this thing since I bought it, and just now the trip that we went on, I did 7 miles and have only used up 1 bar of battery. Still have 4 to go, so I could go back through and do that thing another 3 times if I wanted to.